Hello everyone, LEGO today unveiled new Jurassic World sets for the upcoming fall release season. I'm just going to get right into them, show you the pictures, and give you my personal thoughts. Now these are all inspired by the Camp Cretaceous Netflix special show. There have been 26 episodes of it, so a full season show. It's animated based, so a lot of this stuff is not going to match what you've seen in the Jurassic World movie franchise up to this point, and that's okay, that's by design. So this first one here, Carnotaurus Dinosaur Chase, comes with just 240 pieces, but does include one very large animal, which is going to help to explain its $50 price tag, or 50 euros, or 45 pounds in the UK. Let me get this box out of the way so you can focus on the main things that you actually get here. So this is a new color scheme and a new print set for the Carnotaurus. It's not the same as the one that we got before. It does still have the small arms there and just the regular old legs. A 6x, I haven't watched the show myself, so I don't know if this is supposed to represent something like a Mercedes G-Wagen 6x6, but it is what it is. We'll see just a little bit of interior detail there in just a minute. A very basic helicopter that, you know, has a single seat and it uses that same canopy piece that they use all the time. And then three figures from the show, including Owen, who of course we know from outside of the show. The vehicle, the wheeled vehicle, does hold all three of the minifigures in it. So that's a good thing, I think. This is a render here, obviously. This is a closer look at the figures themselves, and I'll have to go back to the box. Actually, no, I do not need to go back to the box to mention that, obviously, this is Owen, this is Kenji, and this is Sammy over here. I like Sammy's torso print. I like the hibiscus flowers, I think, that they're supposed to represent. I'm only showing one of the lifestyle photos for this because I just think that it does a good job of showing you overall what you get and kind of what the scaling is compared to minifigures that are right there, and also this dinosaur that we know the size of because it's using the same basic size as the T-Rex, even though it's actually the Indominus set for the body and the tail there with the extra spines on the back of it. I personally don't think that this version of Carnotaurus is as cool as the first one that they did. I personally don't like this color scheme and the print that they came up with for this set in particular. So that's not exciting to me. The coolest thing out of this to me is just that new torso print there. This vehicle is fine enough, but it doesn't really do anything. It doesn't have any additional features, anything play-wise to go with this set. And then a helicopter is just a helicopter. So overall, I find this set to be not particularly exciting to me personally. I do think that the price is kind of within the range expected, because LEGO stuff with large animals is always going to be super, super high price. They do charge premium price for those. I'm not shocked at the $50 price point. I do, of course, wish it was cheaper, but yeah, just not shocked at it. Let's check this out. This is something very different. T-Rex dinosaur fossil exhibition. Now, 198 pieces for this one. This will be $30 US. This feels a little bit better for the amount of stuff that you get. And comes with Owen, Darius, and a baby Triceratops with a different color scheme. Yes, give me a baby dinosaur battle pack today. Please, I will buy all of them. And use them. I won't just keep them and then just spin around and flip them on eBay after a few weeks. I will find a place for them because they're just absolutely adorable. Absolutely. Originally designed for the LEGO Jurassic World game, the video game. And when I first saw those in that video game, I was like, please make that physical. And it took them years before they finally did it. So this is intended to be an actual T-Rex fossil. I love what the graphic designer did here. I think it's spot on. I think it could not have been better within reason. Using the full living, you know, tissued and skinned over version of a T-Rex head, but then just adding in the gaps, I forget the specific scientific name of those, but you know what I'm talking about, the holes in the head. I think that looks really good. The rest of it though is kind of a mixed bag, because it has too many colors. It definitely has too many colors. You've got not only the tan and the white, but then the black, and then the dark tan in there, and this is a medium nougat, I'm pretty sure there. That's just too much, and all of this support structure here is unfortunate. However, keep in mind, this is a 7+ set. This is not a set for teens. This is not a set for adult collectors. And as a 7 plus set, this needed to be easy to put together. It could not be super, super bony, right? It could not be super accurate either. It just would have been too fragile. This is actually designed to be played with. You're supposed to take it off the stand, and it's one of those things where, oh no, the fossil has come to life, you know, that kind of thing. It's for fun, and I respect that, but I still don't like, especially the feet. I understand that this needed to be there because this is not enough structure to hold up all this weight, but the legs, yeah, the legs are pretty rough to me. The rest of it is pretty cool, but the legs, and especially down here, down to the feet, pretty rough to me. Give me all the baby Triceratops, always. Okay, the figures, Owen, whatever. this is actually not Darius was his name again. Darius, yes, yeah, that's not bad, you know, for just a regular person. And this just shows the stuff together. Scaling is pretty nice. Obviously, this is scaled to look like the size, you know, a believable size of the standard LEGO Triceratops. Is not trying to be scientifically accurate. It's based on the existing molds that have been around for years and years and years, and I think it's fine in that sense, and I think that the value here is respectable. By comparison, Stigymoloch, or Stigymoloch as some would say, dinosaur escape here, 129 pieces because it's a 4 plus set. Now it comes with 3 minifigures. This isn't Stiggy. This isn't Stiggy, the named character. It's a different Stiggy. And then a new color for the baby Ankylosaurus. Again, let's just pass the box and get straight into the detailed photo where you can see everything this includes. I like this color scheme here with the olive green and then the dark brown as the accent, and tan up on top for the crest, the bony structure on the head. Forget the scientific name for that again. It's not the key thing. It's a 4 plus set, so you're going to have a single piece chassis for this truck. And this truck makes sense to me. This totally makes sense. I think it actually looks good for a 4 plus set as well. Won't be too difficult, I think, to open up the trunk here, or the hood rather, to take the hood off. You might be able to have some storage space under there. Hopefully there will be some storage space under there. But you can see that this turns into a pickup bed when you take this off. So this part here in the center of the screen is part of that, and you can use that to transport the Stiggy around. So that makes sense. That adds some play value. The figures look cool. That pink colored hairpiece looks awesome. Definitely want that. Baby Ankylosaurus. This one is rather colorful with the, I think that's just a teal color. It looks a little bit brighter here than it should, I think. But I think that's just teal. If it's not medium azure, I think it's supposed to be teal. I could be wrong about that, but I do think that it looks too colorful and too bright. But this back here, which is like a baby dinosaur or young dinosaur jungle gym that they've set up here, this is great. This is a very nice build for a 4 plus thing. Makes good use of large pieces. And the idea is that you would put the baby Ankylosaurus on the dark orange colored slide, and it goes down. You know, this is where it hatched from, and then it learns. And yeah, okay, that's actually really cool. So I'm happy about that. I think that the play value for this is excellent. I think the overall design is excellent. This looks weak. The truck looks weak when you take this part off, but when you put the part back on, it makes more sense. Just the price, right? $40 for this. This is everything together. $40 is rough, even for a 4 plus set, and the 4 plus sets are usually overpriced. So not super happy about that at all. Still going to get it. Still going to review it in person once it becomes available. But yeah, that's actually a pretty cool torso there as well. And I'm glad that this is kind of gender neutral. You know, you could use this for a male character if you want. I appreciate that. I'm fine with this one over here, although the waist is a little bit tight, but fanny packs are coming back. I'm just saying. Okay, this is the big one. This is the big one. I do not personally support fanny packs. I just want to be very clear about that. Baryonix Dinosaur Boat Escape. Only 308 pieces, which is shocking for the size of the thing. It looks like a fairly large set, but of course that a large part of the reason for that is that it has a large animal and then a large unitary boat hull. This one's going to go for $80, 80, 80 euros, 75 pounds in the UK. And the length of that boat hull is 15 and a half inches or 40 centimeters right there. Taking everything out, this is all renders here, but it still gives you a respectable idea of what stuff is going to look like. I'm not super happy with this boat personally. I wish that I mean, all this stuff back here that's for holding the animal in just has too much of the yellow, and I don't know, just, I'm sure it works just fine, but I don't like the look of it personally. This little deck right here makes all the sense in the world. I like that. The shape of this up here, superstructure and everything, stuff around the edges, that's cool. It's just this main area back here, the main action feature area, is not my jam. I'll just put it that way. I'll come back to the Baryonix. So this is just a basic little dinghy that also floats. Of course, the main boat will float. The figures look pretty good to me. Baby dino, always a good thing. Not happy with this Baryonix myself. Not at all. I don't like it. Period, paragraph, and end of story. A lot of people had issues with the second generation Indominus hands used for this one. I can even let that pass. I just don't like the color scheme and the printing on it, you know, the design on it. Just not a fan whatsoever. I haven't seen the show, so I don't know if this is actually accurate to what it looks like. I like the little orange spot for the eye, you know, the bald patch there, the softer skin patch. But this will show you a little bit more about the boat, the good parts of the boat. So you open this up. This is, for the sake of scale, a figure is standing there. So figure is standing on the ground. This is the ground level down here. So this is not all that large. You know, it's not a big ship. I think it's large enough, but not big. And then to get a little more use out of the size of the hull, they let you pull the entire superstructure up. And then there's just storage space down below. And there's plenty of it. So that's actually good. I'm satisfied with that. This is how this works. So, you know, it traps in the body, also traps in the head to make sure it doesn't move its head around. It's kind of like how they transport bulls or rhinos, you know, keeping the head there. It's for the safety of the animal. So it makes sense. It makes sense. I just don't like the look of it and don't like the look of the main dino there, unfortunately. You know, just personal opinion. The figures are cool again, just fine. I feel like the waistlines are just so extreme. I'm perfectly fine, and I've said this a million times, and I always have to clarify myself because people like to take things out of context and make a big deal of things that shouldn't be made into a big deal. I like Lego, and I like the fact that with Lego you can take things apart and put different things together with different pieces, and that's why I like to see gender neutral torsos so that kids and adults, everybody, can have maximum versatility for all parts. But I'm perfectly fine with them using or doing some gender-specific torsos from time to time. Just this is really, really extreme with the waistlines on that particular one, and it just looks a little bit silly. Another thing that looks silly on that particular character is the fact that they did not use dual-molded legs, and there's only printing on the front, so it's trying to look like she's got, I think, shorts on and then boots or something like that, but they only printed skin tone just right there across the front. And if you look at it almost feels like they did this on purpose. You can see just right here, there's no printing going along the side of that figure, so it's very awkward. I think there's one other picture from the front. Yes, you see that's supposed to be skin there, but then nothing on the side. So yeah, not particularly well done. I think this is the weakest set of them, I think, for the amount of stuff that you get there and for the price that you pay, even though this is another case where I don't think that the price is completely out of the realm of reasonability, given that this does include a unitary boat hull and a fairly decent sized one at that, and those are always super expensive, and a large animal, and those are always also super expensive. I'd love to see this cheaper. I'd love to see this at about $60 rather than $80 US, but as it is, it's not terrible. This one, pretty happy with, just going back through. The 4 Plus set, definitely overpriced. This one, priced, I think, okay, but not particularly exciting to me. I wish that the main dinosaur looked better. I just thought that the previous one looked better than this. But yeah, those are pretty much my thoughts on these. Let me know in the comments if you have differing thoughts about this stuff. Appreciate your time. I'll talk to you again soon.